In his latest podcast, Gerald Celente is warning about the dollar death and the negative rates coming. Gerald is spot on yet again. The collapse of the dollar is a mathematical certainty. Welcome to the Atlantis Report. In this video, I will show you how the collapse of the dollar is a mathematical certainty. You don't need to be an economist to understand what I'm going to show you. A little common sense will do just fine. The dollar is debt-based currencies created by the Federal Reserve. Now, these central banks, while masquerading as public entities, are actually made up of a consortium of the most potent private banks in the world. When I say that the dollar is debt-based currencies, what this means is that the dollars are loaned into existence. Central banks create money out of thin air by lending money that does not yet exist to their respective governments. And since the vast majority of money in circulation is now digital, such an operation doesn't even require the printing of physical paper. Money and the debt that accompanies it is simply typed into existence. Now, these privately owned central banks don't just loan up to their imaginary money for free, they charge interest. And the money to pay back that interest doesn't yet exist in the system. Since all money is created this way, there's always total debt plus interest to be paid back than there is money. This forces governments to continually return to those banks for more loans, which creates more money and interest. This is obviously a Ponzi scheme, and like all Ponzi schemes, it can only work for so long. The inevitable result when there's a total debt to be paid due to interest than money in existence is that eventually, the debt will reach such astronomical proportions that it will become impossible to service that debt. This is why I said the collapse of the dollar is a mathematical certainty. It's been guaranteed since the beginning of the very nature of our monetary system. You might ask yourself, why anybody in their right mind would set up a system like this that's guaranteed to fail? And the answer is simple, the same reason that any criminal sets up a Ponzi scheme. There's a small group of bankers that get very, very rich at the expense of the public. Before the system begins to falter, and they use that money to buy real assets that maintain their value after the currency falls. Sounds criminal to you? Well, that's cause it is. And you know what, they're gonna get away with it if we don't make a concentrated effort right now to educate the public about the true nature of money and the private central banks which are leading us to the slaughter. And if we let them get away with this time, the next Ponzi scheme is going to be even bigger. There is now about $40 of fancy slips of paper representing wealth for every $1 of real assets. And if you are not personally holding the real assets on land you control, they're going to vanish like the morning mist. If it isn't a precious metal, it isn't worth owning. Like Europe, the US has had its day. The funny money, phony system is coming to an end, the music will soon stop, and the chairs will need butts in seats. It's musical chairs with no chairs, and the music is slowing. Hard assets will rule the day at some point. Exactly which hard assets will be most valuable is another story. It all depends on how deep the inevitable crash goes and what inflation looks like at the time. Fiat could be king for a while. If it gets worse, then precious metals could be king. If it gets worse than that, then real estate maybe. Worse than that, guns, ammo, liquor, and cigarettes, and your precious metals and fiat will be worth jack squat. If there is a recovery to some sort of civilization, then the precious metals will be very worthwhile for all the same reasons as during the last 5,000 years. To get off the very bottom, a fish for a potato, level of barter, some medium must be agreed upon to facilitate broader trades. Precious metals have always been that medium. They need to keep it quiet as long as they can, or at least till the next election. I know lots of dominoes are starting to fall now. But trust me, they can keep these false economy going till they decide it's time to crash everything. The bottom line, free market equals not fair market. This is how to destroy a country. Have a central bank to devalue your currency. Have an army that is continuously in war. Have a media that lies and does continuous propaganda. Let particular interest rule your politicians. Let the government get involved in your schools, dumbing the kids down and indoctrinating them. Let the elites break the country's laws with severe punishments for the common man. Have churches that tickle the ears. Have identity politics. Open your borders wide and allow in people who won't contribute or assimilate. Wall Street rally continues with new records. The stock market has become the magic market. It hasn't followed any of the traditional elements since 2006. By mid-December, if not sooner, that bubble will pop, and the bond bubble will pop quickly thereafter. and the US dollar will begin a 50% dive into the abyss of worthlessness. Unless and until the Fed publicly states it will not interfere in markets, the best you can do is stay away from the casino. A Ponzi scheme wrapped in a shell game stuffed in a burrito. The ultra-rich will cash out, leaving someone else holding the bag. In a deflationary collapse, cash is king. But once you deposit, it is the bank's money. And bank bail-ins are not ruled out. It will be a good time to pick up some shiny relics of the past before central banks reflate everything to infinity and beyond. Physical gold will skyrocket as a safe asset while bonds crash. Then all hell will break loose. And the US can still make its deals. Wall Street gets fat on Main Street's misfortunes. When the mortgage bubble popped in 2008, financiers turned to student debt packaging and marketing loans as student loan asset-backed securities, slabs. Over the last decade, as slabs have become a $200 billion market, the total amount of debt held by American students has more than doubled, surpassing $1.47 trillion. It's no coincidence that college costs more than twice what it did 20 years ago. Student debt is even more attractive than mortgage debt, because it can't be forgiven or dismissed through bankruptcy. And its bearers are too young when they sign the papers to comprehend that they may never pay it off entirely. Colleges have turned students into investments with exploitative income sharing agreements in which the student agrees to give a percentage of their future income to the school after graduation in order to guarantee loan payback. A model uncannily similar to indentured servitude and, perhaps unsurprisingly, developed by Milton Friedman. Debtors' prisons are back with a vengeance, too. SWAT teams and U.S. Marshals are arresting people over unpaid student loan debts. And predatory court fee systems have widened the pool of potential criminals the state can count on as a renewable financial resource. Broke municipalities are so excited when private prison corporations like Geo Group come knocking that they willingly sign agreements pledging to keep the facility a certain percentage full, offering their citizens up on a silver platter to appease their new corporate overlords. All of us non-elites are getting screwed. Our country has been hijacked and serves the international elites only. The average American just wants to work, relax, have a family, friends, a home, etc. Don't be fooled by snake oil salesmen. It isn't complicated. Technology should make life easier, bring costs down, and benefit the human race. Instead, it is used to create a monopoly and increase prices. While the fat cat Wall Street investment bankers revel in their ill-gotten gains, courtesy of our corrupt government. What do the youth on Main Street America have to look forward to? Millennials and Generation Z are confronting an even wider gap than the previous generation between their expectations. The shining city on a hill conservatives unironically insist the US is the example the rest of the world supposedly envies and wants to emulate. And in reality, more than ever, Americans coming of age are finding it impossible to square the crippling debt, decaying infrastructure, impossible expenses, and absence of essential services that characterize their own experience with the propaganda they've internalized since their first day in school. And if the market goes down, it will be to strip pensions and 401ks, certainly not the rich. Another financial crisis, predicted to be the worst in US history, is on its way. We have $250 trillion worth of global debt. It's going to be worse than the Great Depression, said Gerald Celente, founder and director of the Trends Research Institute and widely hailed for warning everyone about what he predicted would be the panic of 2008. From his side, legendary investor Jim Rogers, who co-founded the Quantum Fund with George Soros and achieved returns of over 4,200% over 10 years, said in early 2018 that he expects a $68 trillion biblical crisis poised to wipe out millions of Americans. Again on Fox Business last April, he reiterated, "When I said it's going to be the biggest market downturn in my lifetime, that's not so strange to me. In 2008, we had a problem because of the debt. Debt has skyrocketed since 2008, he added. Institutional investors, also called smart money, got out of the US stock market in 2017. They saw the unsustainable corporate debt, the downgrading of investment-grade corporations like GE to junk, the retail losses based in part on unmanageable rents and prices rising while wages did not, the real estate downturn once the Fed stopped buying commercial mortgages. The rise of the CLO market pushing corporate loans like the mortgage-backed securities market had shifted mortgages just to pool them. Prior to 2008, the recent tripling of what FDIC calls asset problem banks, and of course black swans like Deutsche Bank with $47 trillion in derivatives, Italy and others teetering on too big to fail collapse. Foreign stock markets have seen significant declines already as the European and Latin American economies contract. For example, China's Shanghai index is down 22% for 2018, and emerging markets' currencies are collapsing under the weight of debt owed in American dollars. That said, many economists and investors foresee a dollar crisis after this next debt crisis, because interest rates have almost nowhere to go from this low height. This was the Atlantis Report. Please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.